Habit number two, begin with the end in mind. Dr. Stephan Covey once said that people are working harder than ever, but because they lack the clarity and vision, they aren't getting anywhere. So let me take an example of the animal sheep. Yes, sheep are those animals who don't know what to do, who don't know where to go until and unless they don't follow others. So when they see other sheep going right, they would take that direction. When they see other sheep waiting, or when they see other sheep going left, they would go left. So there are people who would follow others because they're not sure what to do. These people do not prioritize the values, they don't plan things out, they don't set their goals, and that's the reason there is no clarity or vision. Hi, my name is Kaushik Chaki. I'm the founder of Let's Learn L2. And today in this video, I'm going to talk about the second habit mentioned by Stephan Covey in his book, 7 Habits of Highly Effective People. The habit is begin with the end in mind. Now, this habit is based on your imagination. The ability to visualize in your mind what you cannot see at present by your naked eyes. For example, how would be the sales after next 12 months? How would be the attrition rate after next 12 months or next 6 months? What would I be doing after next 5 years? What would I be doing after next 10 years? So this is all about imagination. If you can imagine yourself in future, estimate your actions for the future. Estimate what would be the consequences of the actions you're taking today. Setting the right goals that would help you get a result that you can forecast in future. Now, this is what successful people do, successful leaders do, successful employees do. They try to forecast things. They try to understand what can I do right now that would help me create a better future. So let me give you a real life experience. One of the leaders that I was working with during my tenure as a training specialist in a healthcare organization. So that leader told me that, Kaushik, I have seen some people in our team who try to fight for things that are way less valuable to them. They try to give in their hard work, their time, their energy on things that does not matter much for the team, for their career, or for their personal growth. And we need to understand this fact, that success that have come at an expense of things that were far more valuable to you. We should try to avoid those kind of success. Do not waste your time, your energy, or your efforts behind those things that would give you success, but that success is not valuable to you. It would simply mean that you are achieving victories that are empty. And for this, you need to prioritize what are your values. You need to prioritize what are the tasks that you need to complete that are of relative importance to you, the team, and your manager. Remember, if your ladder is not leaning to the right wall, every single step you take gets you to the wrong place faster. Allow me to illustrate. So you can see there are 3 ladders, and you have one specific task to climb only one ladder to get the job done. Now, if you're not sure which ladder to climb, it would be difficult for us. And if we choose any of these ladders without knowing the end in mind, we would keep on climbing the ladder. But if we have already planned things out, we already know, we are already certain about which ladder to climb and where the results lie, it becomes easy for us to choose the right ladder. So this time, we are using our imagination, we are using our power of forecasting things. Now this helps us to remove that cloud from the ladders, and it becomes easy for us to understand which ladder to climb to achieve those goals, to achieve those targets, or to achieve that result of yours. Now how would this help you? This would help you define your task. Once you start doing this activity, you have a mental first creation of the task that you want to do. And once you start doing that, because you already know the end in mind, you would then have a physical second creation out of it. And then proactively implement those task project or that specific day of yours. Now this process will help you define a physical second creation. Your first creation would be the mental first creation that you already have in your mind, that you have already imagined. And then once you start implementing it proactively, then you would be able to reach that physical second creation. So this is all about your task, your days or your project. You need to do the same exact thing with yourself as well. So you need to be self-aware, you need to be aware of your values, you need to prioritize your values, which I've already told in my previous videos. Why you need to do it? Because if you do not do this task, do not perform this task of self-awareness, if you do not make a conscious effort to visualize yourself on who you are, what do you want in life, then you empower other people or circumstances to shape your life by default. It's about connecting again with your own uniqueness and then defining the personal, moral and ethical guidelines within which you can most happily express and fulfill yourself. So always remember, beginning with the end in mind requires imagination, requires awareness, awareness about self and awareness about your task, your projects and the vision and the goals that you create for yourself and for the process that you're working for. So don't forget to comment on what is your vision, what is the destination where you want to reach, maybe after 5 years, maybe after 10 years. Now, I'm not talking about the destination such as a traveling destination. No, I'm talking about the destination for your life, for your career. Where do you see yourself after 5 years? Where do you see yourself after 10 years? Any of this that you have already planned or you are planning right now or you think to plan after watching this video, let me know in the comments box. If you like the information I've provided in this video, please do push that like button and share it with people who would benefit from it. Thank you so much for watching this video. This is Kaushik Chaki signing out.